personality of discipleship is what we've been talking about here on Strength for Today. And we'll continue today talking about the first characteristic, learning of the Lord as a characteristic of discipleship. We've got to have the desire to know more about Him and the Bible as the only path, and it's the only path you can take to know Him. The only way you can know the Lord is through His Word. Hosea chapter 6 and verse 3 says, "Then shall we know, if we follow on to know the Lord, His going forth is prepared as the morning, and He shall come unto us as the rain, and the latter and former rain into the earth." If we get to know Him more intimately through the Word of God, He'll rub off on us, and we'll become more like Him as we begin to love Him more, and we'll begin to reflect the Christ of the Word of God, the principles that He left us in His Word. The more we reach out to know Him, the more He'll reach out through us to others. And that's the goal, is to clean us up so He can reach through us into the lives of other people. That's His desire. That allows our testimony of faith and obedience to enable His work to continue through us and to work miracles in our lives. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 15 is very clear. "Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth." Another pertinent fact in this desiring to learn of the Lord is having an ongoing and working relationship with the Lord. He's jealous of us, and He's jealous of our time. If we spend more time with the world than we do with Him, He gets jealous of that time. We need to spend time with the Lord. Exodus chapter 34, verse 14 says, "For thou shalt worship no other god, for the Lord whose name is jealous is a jealous God." He wants your time. He wants that Bible reading. He wants that prayer time. It's important that we give Him to them. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 6 says, "For whom the Lord loveth, He chasteneth and scourgeth every son whom He receiveth." If you're His, you're going to serve Him or face chastisement. If you rebel, He'll bend you. If you rebel more, He'll break you. And if He has to, He'll bury you. There's another route, however, in Psalms chapter 94 and verse 14. "For the Lord will not cast off His people, neither will He forsake His inheritance, but judgment shall return unto righteousness, and all the upright in heart shall follow it." If we listen to Him and His rebuke and yield to His direction, His judgment or attention-getting methods will turn us around to where we need to be and lead us right back to Him and His righteousness. If our hearts are tender and soft and sensitive to the Lord, we will lovingly return close to Him, nearby Him, in perfect harmony and fellowship with Him. Draw nigh to Him, and may He be your strength for today and your hope for tomorrow.